Dominique Renault, dexterity and genius. While reinventing the essentials of traditional watchmaking, he made it better by reconciling what seemed to be, until now, irreconcilable. He gambled on an unprecedented escapement face to face with blades to create a unique balance wheel.
Je voulais surprendre et démontrer qu'avec un balancier.
I wanted to surprise and to show that with a heavy balance wheel, we could have extremely tiny pivots. I was aiming for a higher frequency, a higher power reserve, and wanted it all visible on the wrist.
Dominique Renault has long been known to the world of fine watchmaking under the associated name of Renault Papy, virtuoso creator of exceptional movements. He has resurfaced once again as an ingenious inventor, drawing on his deepest roots.
Watchmaking blood has run in my veins for centuries.
The important names of the manufacturers which have, until now, forged the history of the Vallée du Joux belong to his family. Through his mother Marie-Lise, Dominique is descended from the Lecoultres who came from France in the 16th century. He is also descended from the Mélans and the Auberts, traces of whom illustrate watchmaking history books, such as this ancestor at his workbench, whose photo was widely published.
Mon père l'a eu pendant 40 ans au-dessus de son établi de pierriste à la Lecoultre, à la fabrique Lecoultre. C'est pour ça qu'elle est dans un triste état.
Dominique's father was born in Aleppo, son of a French high magistrate. He became a watchmaker and, in Switzerland, met Marie-Lise, who was working, as was he, for Vacheron Constantin. From the time he was very young, Dominique Renault would observe, analyze, and reinvent. Naturally, he became a watchmaker, with the Jura Mountains as his passion and the terrain of his creative inspirations. So as not to lose a minute in the morning and to give him time in the evening to escape to the hills, Dominique invented a mechanical bed which rose up vertically when it was time to awaken. It is still in the family chalet. At the height of his success, Dominique Renault decided at 40 to drop everything to go live in the south of France.
But his passion for watchmaking never left him. That was so lucky. In 2013, he came back to Switzerland with an idea about the heart of a watch. This is when I met him.
À force d'aller dans ton idée, tu viens moins souvent quand même.
His project was so innovative that I did not hesitate. I joined up with him to make his dream come true.
Making the dream a reality was indeed a specialty of Luigino Torrigiani, the man who had earlier created Solar Impulse with Bertrand Piccard, enabling him to acquire the necessary funding. Dominique Renault tested his ideas on models, a technique which he pioneered in watchmaking. Taking inspiration from an old precision clock equipped with a balance wheel positioned vertically on the tip of a blade, he conceived of a system with two blades acting as a balance wheel.
I tried out the concept using two cutter blades. We can see that it works in any position. No more need for a spiral spring, because we are working with a small range and great inertia, as well as a high quality factor.
Dominique Renault retires often to a spot high up in the Jura, usually alone, to give free rein to his dreams and his imagination. Ideas for his new watch were born here.
Dominique Renault is not just a talented watchmaker. He's an artist. He is an inventor able to imagine and visualize the most complex mechanisms in his head and then to make them real. He just needed a team to allow him to express himself.
Thus he devised the 9 lost beat escapement, yet another innovation incorporated into the new watch. The DR01 is at once a laboratory, a pageant worn on the wrist, and also, perhaps, an inspiration for a new generation of watchmakers.